will feel a little weird.
This is Mona Scott Young, CEO of Monami Entertainment, executive producer of VH1's Love & Hip Hop, and a proud Haitian American. And you are on Amour Creole.
When I look into the window, I see you. What I see in you. TSE or MRE.
Exactly.
And I ask myself a simple question.
Why people should tune into Love & Hip Hop is probably that I think there's something there for everyone. It's just relatable stories told by women who are trying to live their lives vicariously through the men that they love, and the hip hop industry, which serves as the backdrop for this, I think affords us an inside glimpse to a world that people often wonder about but don't have a chance to get to know. I think that, you know, if we're honest with ourselves, we will see a little bit of ourselves in each of these women. So I think there are many, many reasons to tune into the show, the least of which are that we tell really great stories with really great people.
A world where the kids can meet and everyone is a celebrity. That's why I follow my own path.
I think something about me that people might be surprised to learn is that I love procedurals. On TV, you know, all those shows that are like detective type, in-depth look, CSI, Law and Order. I love those shows. Those are my guilty pleasures. So at home, you know, my husband knows, he DVRs them all, and I can sit there on the weekends and have a marathon of procedurals. So that's the thing about me people don't really know.
Tell me, what do you see? Is it a face without a name? Calling out for change.
I think one of my number one tips to achieving career success is to know your business, to know what it is you want to do, know it intimately inside and out so that you can do the best job possible. I think once you have that knowledge under your belt, that's something that no one can take away from you, and you use that to fuel everything you do. I think working hard and being diligent and being focused and just being determined, not letting anything deter standing your way. That's the best advice I can give. On the horizon, I have some pretty exciting things happening with Missy Elliott, a longtime client of mine. She's been out of the public eye for about 7 years, and I think we're finally ready to release an album. She and Timbaland have gone back to Virginia, where it all started. They've put together an incredible body of work, so we're very, very excited about this album. I also have a young artist by the name of Destiny that I'm going to be developing and working on. She's out of Florida, 17 years old, of Jamaican descent, so I'm very excited about her as well. So look out for those projects. When I think Caribbean American, I think incredible work ethic, I think incredible integrity, I think, you know, people who just have built this country on their backs and who, you know, are such an important part of, for me personally, a culture that I love. Everything about going back to the islands, even if it's not Haiti where I'm from, but I love, you know, Jamaica, and I've spent a lot of time there. I just think that there's an amazing, amazing work ethic that just comes from watching our families work so hard to achieve their dreams, that it's just instilled in us. So when I think about Caribbean American, I think of how we've helped change this country by bringing all of our work ethic and our integrity here to the United States.